En Nijmegen is in the east of the Netherlands, so near the border of Germany, and it's about a 7-hour drive by bike. I have a background in marketing and communication, but I combined it with technical interest in technical stuff and how people use technical stuff. I'm a volunteer in the Joomla community, and in Nijmegen, I organized the Open Coffee Nijmegen, and I started a Linux user group a couple of years ago. I love Linux. In this presentation, I will talk about rapid application development. I will use FOF as example, and I will show you how to write a backend component. There is also a part two, and in part two, I show you how to create the front-end component of this stuff. And I will also do a demo about how I set up my local environment. And I'm not talking about an LAMP stack. I already have it. But I am talking about how to use GitHub and how to synchronize my local web with GitHub, with only my project in GitHub. If you have your if you want to write a web application, you can write everything from scratch, and you have to write everything, the database connection, and every time you have to ask stuff from the database, you have to connect to the database again. You can also use Joomla as a sort of a framework. If you write a Joomla component, then you can use Joomla's database object. So first you initiate the database object, and then you just talk to the database object, and the database object communicates with MySQL. So you don't have to program that every all that stuff. It's the same with the layout. You can use Joomla's templates. You can use MVC, and if you write stuff in your component, people can override your template output in the template override. And of course, if you use Joomla, you can add hooks to your extension so that plugins can hook into your extension and run. If we look at the functionality of a normal backend component, you will see four things. Most of the components have categories and items. And if you look at the categories, you usually have a list of categories, and with this list you can do things like enable or disable or delete or create a new category. And if you create or edit a category, you will get a category form. So that's the second view. And it's the same with items. You have a list of items, and you have an edit form for the items. So this is the functionality you always have in the back end. In the front end, it's basically the same. You will have a list of categories and a single category, and the same with items. So rapid application development takes use of this because you always have those four, the list and the form of a category, list form of an item. They created stuff so you can easily write your own components. They abstracted common functions. Some common functionality, and it's based on conventions. So you have to know how to name your XML files and what to put in the XML files to use FOF and to create your component. There is another component called Nuku. It's made by Johan Janssens. It's one of the core architects of Joomla 1.5, and he created Nuku, and it's a framework for Nuku content, but also for extensions they currently have. Nicholas from Akiba created his own because there were some things in Nuku he didn't like, and programmers like to build their own stuff. And he created a nice thing called a framework, which got integrated in Joomla in 3.2, and it's used as base for Akiba backup. It's not a standalone extension or a standalone thing. You have to use Joomla, and it uses Joomla's MVC structure. It should be backwards compatible. Because it uses a lot of conventions, you don't have to write all code. So development should be faster with less bugs. A lot of stuff is automagic. I like this word. Because you create some database field, there is functionality added automatically, or automagically, I have to say. Okay. So you have RAD, FOF, but also F0F. FOF was the first, then FOF got into Joomla in the framework, in the Joomla core, and then it was called RAD. But Nicholas was not really happy with the development of RAD and what he wanted to put in RAD. So he forked his original FOF into F0F. I'm not really happy with the name because an O and a zero look really like each other. So if you run into problems, always check if it's an O or a zero. So a Joomla component with FOF. You have to install a local environment. I use Linux and I installed Apache Mambo, MySQL and PHP on it. I use Joomla 3.3 and I use NetBeans. I like NetBeans, but Victor Vogel was really enthusiastic about Eclipse, PHP Storm, and other people as well, so I have to look into that. Okay. My component. I want to write a component called db8locate. db8 is the name of my company, and I use this naming convention for my own extensions so that my extensions will always be in the same position when I see lists like database tables or components or file structures. So, and it has to do something with locations. So this is the name of my component, and then everything in my component is called db8locate. So my component name is com_db8locate. It's the same with how I did it with regular components. And the database table will be called db8locate_items. And what I want to accomplish is the following. Okay. I have to log in and now move. So, this is difficult. Components, db8locate. Oh, yes. This is, oh, yes, sorry. I was. I was fiddling around with it and I was testing stuff. And one of the tests I did was, what happens if I rename the backend? And that's for real. I mean, this is the, here you see it's called db8locate version 2. So if I go to this one, yes. So I created a component which has location items, location categories, and I can add new ones. I can publish or unpublish them just by clicking on them. And I can always, I think the sorting works also. And this is done automatically, but I will go into that in a minute. So this is the list view of items, and this is the form view, where I can add my own stuff in the form, and it will be saved into the database. So this is my backend component I will show you right now. I was here. Okay. the basic component for the backend. This is what you have to do. We have to create an entry point. This is normal in Joomla. If you create your own component, you also have a backend entry point. An entry point. We have to create a dispatcher configuration. Here you will tell FOF what a view you want to set as default. You have to create some SQL definition. It's not really necessary, but I like it because I don't like to do it manually. Because you can also just add a SQL database and then you can skip this one, but I will show you how to do it with it. We have to create an XML manifest. This will contain everything about the installation. So which files are should be installed, stuff about your extension. I create two different views, a list view of items and a form view of items. And also create language files, of course. If you look at this, do you see something in particular? The categories are missing. I didn't create categories. I will come to that in a minute because I will use Joomla's categories. So first of all, the entry point. It's called db8locate.php, and this is what you have to put in it. So this is just to prevent browsing of direct access. And here you include the library, the FOF library. Here is a warning that if the library can't be included, so you don't have FOF in the background, it should quit. And here you start the dispatcher of FOF. This is my component name, and here I say dispatch. This is all. It doesn't work when you do it like this, because you have to do other stuff as well, like create the dispatcher configuration. I want to have the default view the items. So the list of items should be default. And I have to create an SQL database, a MySQL database. And here it starts to be tricky because you have to take into account that there are some conventions, like if you say create database, create table, the table name should be in plural. So my items are in the table. db8locate underscore items with the S. Second, the ID field. Joomla uses the ID called ID, so the content table has ID as the record. How do you say the identification? In your component, you should use item underscore ID as the item ID, and this is the singular name of the table. This the table is called items, so this should be item and ID. I want to have a title in it. This is just you can do anything you want. I use the word title, and then you have to create a primary key. So this is all. This is just the SQL code of it. This is what is in my SQL. install.sql. By the way, my sheets will be available, and the code is also available after this presentation. So the XML manifest, this is just Joomla. Only the file driver, my SQL. I don't know if this is exactly the same how Joomla does it, but this is the same as in Joomla. I install db8locate.php and fof.xml. Now, when the component is ready, I should add other files as well here. This is the list view. So if I add in my administrator components, com db8locate in the views, I create a view called items. So it will be the list. And then it's the TMPL for the template. And the template is called form.default.xml. And this is an XML file that defines how the lists in backend should be listed. Like there should be a header, so it should say item of ID, title, etc. There should be pagination if it's more than the default Joomla pagination. So if you say Joomla, I want to have 20 items on the page, and you have 25, you will have pagination if it says one. Otherwise, it isn't available. This is the title. If there is nothing in the database, it should display this title, no records. And here you have the header set. And in the header set defines which column names you have. So in this case, you have title. It's searchable, so I can search on it. And here you have to create a link from the titles to the item so you can edit it. So this is the URL to edit it, like view item instead of items. So you go to the singular one and you have to pass the ID of the item. And this is the form where you can just add stuff. And there is validation in it. And this is just like JForms in Joomla. Do you know JForms in Joomla? Okay, this is the same syntax. So the installation is really simple. If you created this code and you go to Extension Manager, Discover, you will discover it and install it, and it works. You will see something like this, items. You will see something like this. Can somebody tell me why this is? Yes, exactly. The language is missing. The same here. And this is if you edit one, same item, you have the no items. I mean, no language labels. So this is what I do. If I save an item, I have now two items in it. But yeah, we don't have a language. So we have to create a language file. Language file, just like Joomla. We have two in the backend, two language files. We have files that have sys.id at the end, which are Joomla's system files. Those language files are in the memory all the time, because if you have to create a menu item, this is the name where Joomla takes. I don't know what your convention is of using language files. You can put it in the language folder. I prefer to put it in my own component folder, so I have everything together. Okay. The ini file is just everything your own component has to say when it's triggered. So no records, location items, etc. In the past, I was just looking at all the language labels I had to translate. I copied those, put in the file, and then I translated those. Till someone said, yeah, Peter, but you can switch on the debug mode of Joomla, debug language. And then at the bottom of the website, you have all the untranslated language files, strings. So you just copy those, hoppa, and then translate it, which is really convenient. So after I added my language files, everything is translated. You can make an extension which has items in it, but you also want to publish or depublish it. You have to build in a switch. So what you have to do is you have to create a new in the table, add a new field, and the new field has to be named enabled. This is important. It's not published, and it doesn't work. FOF works with a field called enabled. And if you say default one, it's published by default. So if you create a new item, it's published. And we have to add this button to the list of extension, the list of items, but also to the view. So if you go again to the views and on the items, so the list, you edit this file and you add to the header set on the top this part of this line of code published, and in the field set name you say enabled published. This is also JForm style. You will have enabled over here. Oh, and you have a filter enabled because. So you can filter the enabled or the disabled ones, and here you can just enable or disable those. Or you just select them here and use the publish or unpublish. Everything works. Oh yeah, in the form. Maybe you want to have the option in the form as well, because if you look at the components of Joomla, like the com content, and you are writing an article, in article you can say publish or unpublish. So you can do it in the form of your item, so the single one as well. And then you have a new field called status published, or you can select unpublished. Something else which is important, the order of items. Order of items, you just add a new table, a new field, which is called ordering. And this is also automatic. Same, I will skip over this. It's exactly the same. You will have the order, and you can also click on it and drag it, like just Joomla extension, Joomla content articles. Categories, this gets interesting. Because we already have categories in Joomla, and if you look at the categories in Joomla, especially if you look into the database table of this categories, the categories is called, you will notice that there's a lot of categories, but some categories are not com content, but are com web links or com something else. I want to use categories for my db8 locate, so it will be com underscore db8 locate as type. What I have to do, I have to add a new field to my table. The field is called get ID, and this is what I do to enter it. If I have if I have the database ready, I don't do this manually. I will just create a copy of it, export, and then I will import the export in my SQL. So this is what you have to do. If you go to administration components and db8 locate views items, so the plural, you go to the template file again, the form default, so the thing, the file that lists the whole everything. You add a new header set which says type is category, and you say a field names items, and here I say type is SQL, and in SQL I look for every I look for all the entries that are in the categories table. Now it will say root, because I haven't created any categories for my component yet. If you look at the items, so I have they have all zeros, and it's not yet categories. So what I have to do is I have to create something in the views for the form. So I add a new field to my form of the item. So now I have a category list, and I didn't translate it because I used jcategory, which is a system constant of Joomla. This is already all your category. It's empty because I don't have categories yet. So what I have to do is I want to create a toolbar. And if I click on it, I go to categories. And this is what you have to do. It's a bit too much to explain here. But it's a file called toolbar.php. You put it in your component. And you will have location categories. If you click this button, you should go to the category manager, and you want in the category manager you only have the category, and you want to have the item as well in it. So you have to create something in a helper file to have a button so you can go back. Otherwise, you will stay in the categories. So if you click it, it doesn't work. You will get an error, something like this. I didn't understand until I started to look in the code. And then I noticed something with access levels. I didn't take into account that if you create something which it should have access to other fields or other parts as well. There are two kinds of access levels. The first one is access to application. You have to create a file called access.xml, and in this access file you have to define what your component can do, what an admin can do on your component, but also what you can do in the category. So core manage and a new one, I have to create new categories. So you have to use all these kinds of fields. I'm not really sure about everything in this file. I used an example file, which worked terrifically. But there is also another kind of access level, and it's the levels in Joomla itself, for especially the front end. So if you want to have something like guest or registered, you have to put something in the code. I will not go into that. It's just the same what I did before. And if you look in the example components, you will see how it's done. So we have the parameters. What you would like is you would like to create some default parameters for your component. And you can do that by adding a config.xml file. And if you have the config.xml file, you can put some parameters in it. It's just like never mind. This is very important here in Germany and also in Holland. In England, they mostly use just English. But we know, sorry? Yeah. We would like to have multiple languages in our extension. And this is really easy. We just add a new field in the database. In this case, you have to make sure that it's an asterisk, because it should default should say all languages. And again, you go to the views and then items and then form default. You add something to the header set and something to the field name set, and then you should have the languages in the list. And you do the same to have it in the form, so you can select languages. You will be able, if you implemented this, you will be able to select all the languages that are configured in the language manager, and then the content languages. So this is the result. I now have language and also here a select button, so I can select one of the languages. So magic fields. I talked about the enabled field, about the category field, about the language field. There are also fields for modified by, locked by, and the hits. If you just add those, they will be used. So if you add a hits in your table, it will count. You don't have to do anything. It will count the amount of visitors that open the item on the front end. Tags. Who uses tags? Okay. The other people, why don't you use tags? Okay. When you use tags, there are two tables that are important. One is called the tags. Here you put your tags in, and the tags have an ID. And there is another one, and it's called content item underscore tag underscore map. Here, those tags are mapped to content items. You can create one for your extension as well. Just add this JTAG desk to the form.form. So to the single form when you edit it. And if you put it in this file, you will be able to select tags or to create new tags. There's one problem. I'm not sure if it's working right now, but in the past, in 3.2.3, it was not working because the tags need JTable and we don't have JTable. I didn't do anything with JTable. So now I have a component that has a lot of fields, but nothing interesting. I mean, just titles and that's it. But I want to create a database with addresses and locations like latitude and longitude. So I have to add some new fields. These are the fields I just add, like address, city, latitude and longitude, and website. I just added to the database table. I added it to the list and to the edit forms as well. This is the list view with the latitude and longitude and the cat. That's it. And oh yeah, if you have done that, you have a component ready. But your SQL file, where everything is, the SQL database is defined, you have to update it with a new database structure. Furthermore, I had a problem with the saving of my form, because if you have the check enabled, to that some required fields are really required, and you miss one, it will just refresh the page, and you have to fill out the form again. So you have to put something in like save state. This is a bit too technical now. And also the form got too long, so I split it up in three parts using a span field. This is how Joomla components work also. Some other things I want to do. I have the code ready in my extension, but not yet in what I have here. But you could look up the addresses in Google. And if you look the addresses in Google, you will retrieve the coordinates and you put it in a database. So it's really handy. You have all the addresses and you can just select all and click a button, and all the addresses, the coordinates are just looked up. What you have to do is you have to create some code to look up an address in the Google API. You have to create a button to trigger it, and you have to create some handling in the controller. Okay. That was the back end. The front end I will do in my next presentation, but if you look at the front end, you need these parts in the front end. An entry point again, a list view, single item, language files, and in the next presentation I will do something about how I use GitHub and how I create my local environment. I will give a demo of that. So some tools you can use when you develop FOF components. Errors are really difficult in FOF, because you are using a framework which has classes. If something goes wrong, it goes wrong at other places than you expect. So the first of all, cache. Who has had problems with cache? Yeah, everyone. If you do something with FOF, everything is cached as well, especially if you change something in the database structure. You should empty your cache and then start again. Debug. If you have run into problems, the problem can be somewhere else than where you expect it. For instance, in the backend I had this problem. And the problem was not in the backend, but it was because in the front end I had some error. So what you have to do if you don't know where the problem is, just go to the front end, rename your front end part of a component, go to the back end, and if it's solved, you know it's the front end that's caused the problem. And in my case, the front end error, I had to rebuild an XML file step by step. So I just copy everything out of it. I just start with it, end with it, and just paste parts in it and test every time. And every time when there are no problems, you know it's okay. And then you will find the error. And this also works. But I heard Victor Vogel did a presentation about tools for developers, and he uses Xdebug. You can find some documentation on Akiba Backup Documentation FOF. There's a mailing list, a lot of source code on GitHub, and these are a couple of examples you can find on the internet with Akiba, with FOF. This is the end. I would like to tell that it's really nice to use this, but I find it really complex. Sometimes I use this. Sometimes I use just normal Joomla code to write extensions. Especially when I want to do more than the default, it's difficult because you have to create some sort of overrides, and I find it difficult to find how to accomplish that. So, are there any questions? Okay, I have to publish them. I will publish them at my dba.nl. I will tweet about it. My Twitter account is pe7er. And I will send it to the organization, so it will be published somewhere here. I think I will make them available today at my website, dba.nl. They are already at SlideShare, but I have to publish them. Okay. Welcome again. I think, welcome again to my presentation about a front-end development of a FOF component. If I look to the at the audience, I think I scared away half of the audience. The other audience.
Most of the people are interested in tech at
the moment. Oh, okay. So this is my part. Are there any people who are here now new that didn't attend my first session about this? Yeah, okay. Other people? Yes, okay. Well, yes. Yeah, if you use FOF, maybe you can save 80% of your code. However, I think it's really complicated. And if you want to do other stuff than what you can configure with XML, you have to use PHP. It gets more complicated. And if you want to override stuff in the framework, it's possible, but you have to use you have to have knowledge about how the framework is. So. You have to be a really hardcore programmer. I'm not a really hardcore programmer. Nicholas is. In Holland, if I have questions, I ask Ronald Dalmulder. Or in Australia, you have Tim Plummer. They have more way more knowledge about this, and they can help do it with overrides. Sometimes I use FOF for real components, and when it's for customers who have a lot of questions about changes, then I look at it again and I think, maybe it's now time to go to Joomla and just do a Joomla component. But then I reuse my database structure, my template layouts, I reuse those. So, 80% less, I think. It's an estimate of Nicholas. So, hello, my name is Peter Martin. I'm from Nijmegen, the Netherlands. If you look here, this is Nijmegen, this is Germany. It's about 28-hour walk from here. And I already told about this. I'm a Linux fanatic. I have a Raspberry Pi too, and the third one will arrive soon. I use it for my daughter. I organize Open Coffee and Linux Nijmegen, and I help out in the Joomla community in the leadership team, and as global moderator at the forum. Part one was about developing a component using FOF in the backend. And this part is about developing a component for the front end. And because it's really fast, it's really really little code, I will also tell about how I develop components using GitHub, and I will give a demo about that. What I told in the first session was, you can do everything yourself from scratch, write all the PHP code, or you can use Joomla's Joomla and make a Joomla component. So you use Joomla's framework work with all these kinds of stuff. You don't have to program it yourself. You can just reuse it. If you look at backend components, you have a category list, a form, a list item, and an edit form for an item. If you look at the front end, you have a similar kind of views. You have a list of categories, and you have a single category if you want to. You have a list of items, and you have a single item with details of this item. I only have lists, views, so I didn't do any edits in the front end. I just got a question about it. When you start to use edit in the front end, it becomes more difficult. It's possible. I think there is the come to do example of Nicholas has, I think, front-end editing. I'm not sure. So rapid application development again. We use a lot of conventions, and that's it. Less code, 80%. And because it's less code, it's faster and less bugs. But yeah, it's more difficult, especially when you run into errors. Yeah, this is what I already told in the first session, so I will skip it. Component using FOF. I have this component, what I want to develop, and I have a local environment. I have Joomla 3.3, I use Git, and I will show GitHub with it, and NetBeans. My goal is to create a component to list addresses on the map. And I showed it in, I'll just show it in a minute. So the basic backend components, these are the things you need in a backend component. Always an entry point, a configuration file for your default view, an SQL definition of the table, an XML file for installation, a list of all the items you have in the backend, a form to create new ones or edit the existing ones, and language files. So when you look at the front end, you have a similar structure, but with less code. I mean, you need an entry point. It's exactly the same entry point you use in the backend, just the same code. I have a list of items, and what I did, I had to create two files, and I had a single item details, and I just created two files to create that. And of course, language files. I always put my language files in my component, because then I have everything next to each other. And if I upload it to GitHub, I have everything ready. I don't have to go to the language directory, find my component, copy it. It's a lot of problems. So this is the entry point of my my front-end component. Always use the statement to make it impossible to trigger the file via the browser. If you put it in the browser, it won't run. Check if the FOF library is loaded. And if it's not loaded, just quit with the message, FOF is not installed. And here, you start you dispatch your com-db8 locate. And then you have to create a list for the view. And this is what I did for the view. I wanted to have city, region, country, category in a list. Something which is really important, and I did it wrong the first time, you have to set show enabled 1. If you don't show enabled 1, it will show also the zeros. So the stuff that is unpublished. So be careful. This, you need to put this in your extension. I mean, in your configuration file. In my previous session, I talked about writing a component using Joomla's com category. So I don't have to create the categories. I can let Joomla create the categories for me, for my component. And I have a category a category field in my component. And the category field is with SQL as type. This is a JForm format. And I use SQL, and this is a statement to get the categories for my component. And this is the result. I have a couple of items with titles and the category. These are with SQL code, loaded with SQL code. This is what you'd have to do in the front-end form. It says form.item. The name is form, and I think it's a bit confusing, but because it's not really a form. You don't add stuff. But it's the convention. And when you add this, and type is read, so it will read stuff, you get just a really simple view. This is all it does. Language files, the same. If you use debug language, you can see all the untranslated language strings, and you can copy those and use in your extension. You can do more with views. For instance, you can combine XML and PHP together. If you use XML, you just configure how to show stuff. And if you use PHP, you can do other things as well, like loading a Google map. So what you have to do is you create a default.php, and in this default.php, you load the templates you use with the form default.xml. You do it like this, and you get something like this. This is what I had before, and this is what I have now, just a map from above it. Something else. You can add stuff to the URL of the... You can put stuff in the URL and you get extra views. So you can export the data you see in the item list. If you do n format is CSV, it will export your data as CSV. If you do n format is JSON, it will add export it as JSON. But this only works if you use the XML method of viewing. If you use this and you put the n format is JSON, this gives errors because there is also other stuff in it. It doesn't work. You can also do media file overrides. I haven't done it. This is just from an example. And now I will show how I work, how I create my extensions, modules, etc. on my local environment using GitHub. Are there any questions so far? Yeah? I have to where I put the code. I put it in my. I created a new file, and it's called tmpl default.php, and there I first load the Google map, and I also have a sort of tiny script that adds the different coordinates on it, and then. The view template this get rendered is triggered next to it, so it will be displayed on underneath it. Okay, I'll try to. The last one, yes, last. It's flexible, dynamic.
Yeah, to solve the problem with the format is just to put the map generation in your case.
Yeah. Yeah, good solution. I hadn't thought about that, but I don't use the XML export, but it's good. Yeah, you better trigger that, otherwise people might run into errors if they try it. Yeah. Yeah. Are there any other questions now? I try to, maybe I have it on my laptop. I hope that I can show you a part of it, of the code. First, other questions? Then I will show how I work on my local machine. By the way, how much time do we have left? 30 minutes, 20 minutes? More than 30 minutes. Great. Okay, what I always do, and I will show it now here in this session as well, I go to GitHub. I have my own account over there, PE7ER, and I create a new repository. In this case, I will create a repository called JDDE. After I created this, I will create a local website. I can call it Joomla Day Germany or whatever. It doesn't have to be the same. I will use NetBeans and import it as a project. So I start a new project in NetBeans. I will show that as well. And then I will create a folder for my Git development. I will show it. And what I do is I will check out the stuff I created on GitHub to this new folder. And then in a new folder, I will create a couple of directories, a front end and a back end directory. I will create an XML file. And then I will create symbolic links. So what I do is I will let the local web server believe that my component is in my component directory, but actually it's in another folder. It's in the development folder outside of my website, but it will just get it from there. this is how you do it with on Linux. Who is using Linux here? Okay, who is using Macintosh? You can create symbolic links at Macintosh as well, but I'm not sure about Windows. I think there are other options at Windows. For Windows?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, but are there other options? Never mind. I created a symbolic link at the front end as well, and then I will add the stuff to my local repository, and then I commit back to GitHub, so you can download it. Other people can download it or add it. So
very important which direction you go
here. Yeah.
I tried that too, but link the other way
around. Oh, yes.
Symbolic links does not.
Yes, they are committed, but they are text files. yeah, I know. I run into the same problem. Yeah, tell me about it. Oh. So now I have to get one screen, so I can work on one screen. Layout, open, one screen. I have my whole screen? No. Layout, open, two screens. How much of my screen do you see? Okay, so I have to say view. This is my resolution 1024, I think. Yes, this is it. Yeah, okay, I have my whole, the whole screen is also here. Okay, so I have to get stuff here. Hop. So first of all, I have my local host, and then I... Oh. I created a new folder. Joomla DE. Joomla DE. Oops, okay. I like the command line sometimes, especially when it goes very fast. I have to create a database. I have a local PHP myadmin on my computer, and come on. Meanwhile, database Joomla DDA create. Then I have my Joomla day. Why does it, I don't see it? Oh, okay. Oh, I don't have the whole browser, but I can manage. Oh, admin. And people start to laugh all the time. I don't have my whole screen. Oh no. Oops, okay. Yes. Next. And the database was called Joomla Day. Joomla Day DA without a point. I install nothing. And I will start my NetBeans. I remove the installation, go to the admin. I say admin, login. Oh, login. Okay, then I will go to NetBeans. I will create a new project. Who works with NetBeans? Okay, I create a new extension, existing source, because I have it already here. I say browse. It should be on the Joomla DA, open. I always say PHP 5.4, and I put the data in a separate directory. I have my administrator. So I end up showing the backend now as well. Components, and there is no db8 locate here. So what I do is I go to GitHub. And GitHub, I go to repositories. I forgot to go to the hairdresser, so I look different there. New. And my repository is called JDDE. It's a public repository, and I would like to have a README with it. This is it. Who uses Git? Okay, so the other people who don't use Git, this is Git. Is it really powerful? If I go... this is my command line. And in the command line, I have my website, it's www. There I have all my website, but I also have a folder called dev. And dev has nothing yet there. Let's show you with this editor, www, dev. There's nothing in it. So I have this GitHub website. In GitHub, you have a clone option, and you can clone a URL. So I go to this, I go back and I say clone, a git clone and this URL. Now it will just copy everything, which is just one file, from there to here. I have a JDDE folder in it, and there is a .git, which has some stuff for git, it's a system file, and a README, which has nothing in it. So what I will do now is I will create two folders. One folder is called admin, and the other is called site. I use these because I think it's convenient, but you can use other names as well. So I have those.
If you think further, going to tests and so on. It's convenient to make another level and have a source folder.
Yeah.
In which you have the admin inside. So you have source and tests and build directly. So
okay. Level. Yeah, I don't do testing and building, so. Yeah, you're right. Okay, this is the easy way how you should not do it, maybe how you should start, but you should end up with more folders and do it the proper way. Maybe even use Thing, because Thing is a good program to build stuff. This is just the fast way. It's okay, don't tell this at home, this. So I have this folder. the admin folder. And if you use Linux, and maybe also in Windows and other, if you do something like Control L, you will get the location of the in the browser. So I will use it because I'm lazy. I have to create a symbolic link. You do it with LN. S is symbolic, and now I have to look up because I always do it wrong. I first have to say the source, which will be my admin folder, and then I have to specify where the symbolic link should be put. And the symbolic link should be put in my website, this www.joomladay.de, administrator, components, and here I would like to create com_db8locate. It's not here yet. So I also copy this. Components com db8locate. Yes. So if I go to my terminal again, I copy it over there, and I just created a symbolic link. If I look here, you see com db8 locate, and there is a sort of arrow in front of it. So this is symbolic. If I look here, there's nothing in it, but now I'm actually looking in another folder I just created in my dev folder. So I just created two files, and if I look in my editor, EDE, I also have to db8 locate for the backend. You have to do the same for the front end. It's not here yet, and this is convenient because the front end should be without administrator, and it should not be admin but site. So now I have also in the front end my folder for my component. I told you about you have to create a dispatcher. And you have to create, so I will create a dispatcher. I think I have to go to my, yes. I have to go to my, how many, how much? 3 minutes. Okay, then I will do it differently. Okay, I hope it works. I'm going to smuggle, because I also have already a repository called db8locate. Hey, and I just go to git, control C. I am in ls dev, just git clone, and then I will go with my extension to www.dev. db8locate. I have the admin folder with all the stuff. This is not how I do it normally. Yeah. So I just copied from the one to the other one. And if I go to my front end here, you see, I have all the files now here. It's all db8locate in my website. If I look at my SQL file, this is what I want to install. This is just the database structure I want to create. And if I have the database structure, and if I have my backend manifest file ready, I can just use Discover to install it. So I go to the backend of my website, extension manager, discover, and I have db8locate. I can install it. And if everything goes okay, I should have a component called db8locate. And it says no location items. I can create one. And there are stuff in it. Oh yeah. This is my location. Save and new. Oh, invalid form. Oh, there is something wrong with this form. Of course, it's a demo. Oh, yes. Oh, I don't have categories yet. Oh, I go to categories, new. This is, by the way, com categories of Joomla, which is using my extension. So it says extensions com db8 locate, because it says db8 locate. The category manager is using my extension as category manager. You can't. If I need a category with a lot of extra fields, it's just another item. I create my own categories in my own component. But if it's just a nesting structure, because I just can create a second. So this is now a second level under my other one. If I go back to the items, this is done with a toolbar, toolbar.php. And now I create a new one. Fill out the forms and select the second category. So I have some weird category now. Oh, and a category, yes, and a category. And if I look at the front end, then I will see nothing, because I didn't create a menu item for it yet. So in the back end, menu item, new. I select this, and this is difficult because my extension is on the bottom, and if I click it, nothing happens. So if you click it one time, you will see here it opens up a bit. You have to drop down, locate item. If your component is not called db8 locate, but something else and it's higher in the list, you don't have this problem. So on the front end, I have a component with, this is the map. I didn't use the map here yet because there are no coordinates. But these are the extensions. There's only in one, and it shows one. I don't know why. Let me go back to the front end view. In the front end view of my db8 locate, I have the entry point. And if I look at the items, because it's multiple, this is my metadata, which makes it possible to select categories in my menu item. This is the TMPL. The form default is how everything should be of all the fields, which are under the map. And with default.php, this is the default.php. And here I trigger Google Map with add script. You wanted to know about Google? This is Google. Document add script maps Google scripts, and then I just trigger the API of Google. I have something called marker clusterer, because if you have a lot of items, you want to have them clustered, because Google only shows 2,000 items if you have 2,000 items, so therefore it's clustered. And here it starts. This is just code for Google. First of all, I initialize stuff, and here I create for the items I have in my that were returned by FOF. I create latitude and longitude positions, and those are put on the map. So if I go to my database, and it's called, because there is an error in the form, so I go directly to my database. And if I say edit, and I put, where's the edit? Google. Latitude and longitude. Oh, yes. 56.9. Not 9. And longitude is 6.3. And the other one is this one. And we put there, where's the latitude, longitude? Latitude 68 and 0.9. Go. If I go to the front end of my extension, it should have Google, but it lists only one location because on the it says I have to. I did something wrong because I specified somewhere that it should only display the category for the first one. Yes, so if I go to my component and I say that the second category should be not the second but the first, and it should list two items on the map. Exciting, ruffle, ruffle, ruffle. And you see here, this is the clustering. So if I go, one is in the sea now. this is the clustering of if you cluster items. So this is how you can write your extensions. Are there any questions? No, the documentation is available at the Akiba website. Let me show you. Yes. This is the main documentation website. It's on the Akiba Backup website because it's made by Nicholas of Akiba Backup. Here, everything is documented. Sometimes I find it hard to read because it's really, really technical. There is also a mailing list. You can ask questions over there, and Nicholas is really helpful. And there are a couple of other people who know a lot about the framework who can help you out. You can look at the source code of FOF. It's in GitHub of Akiba, but it's also in Joomla itself, of course. So you can look in the libraries, FOF, and then you can investigate stuff. There are a couple of examples available. A to-do example, contact us. Those are also made by Nicholas. And Tim Plummer wrote a com timesheet. And this is he's from Australia, and he has it also on GitHub. There are a couple of extensions called Akiba Backup and Ticket System that use FOF, but not in the way I showed you, because I showed you how to use FOF using XML configuration files, and those use just plain PHP, but also trigger the FOF framework. So, yeah, but sometimes you can get information from it. Yeah? Yes, oh sorry, yes. It's difficult. If you always install Akiba on your website, you can also use FOF, but you have to be careful because if you do things like the entry point, if you say here F0F dispatcher, you have to include the F0F. So you have to be consistent, because I think if you use them all together, I think you might have problems. Okay. I had a problem that I was using one, and I had an FOF or some zero and an O. Yeah. Other questions? Okay, thank you.